says now.
Oh, well, hi, everybody. This is the Human Colony Saturday webinar. Today is the 12th of, well, excuse me, today is the 24th of December, 2016. And today we have a fun group with us. We were supposed to have three channelers for a mini channel panel, but Karen Newman was unable to make it today because of unforeseen circumstances. She's fine, but it turns out that we will be having Wendy from Languages of Lights and Brian Sims joining us today to channel for us. And today, because things are kind of a little bit off kilter, we weren't expecting some things to come up. We are going to actually be doing things a little bit differently. It's going to be a little more interactive. And we're just going to kind of see how this goes. So I am still going to be selecting some questions to ask that are best for the channelers who are speaking. We're also having a quick little bit with Will, who has joined us, who's going to be doing maybe some sort of a guided meditation or something to kind of get us in high spirits for the festive season we're in right now. So good morning, Wendy and Brian.
Good morning, everyone. Love you. Good to see you all here today. Have wonderful holidays.
Hello, hello, everyone. Tuning in live and in style.
There we go, that voice.
Good morning, Brian.
Awesome. All right. So, Brian, I believe that you had said that you would be willing to go first, and I did not hear even what Will had said. Let's do some blessings and stuff beforehand, and I guess I should take a moment to explain. But Will, did you care if you do the meditation in the middle? I guess
it does. We'll wing it. Don't worry about it. We'll wing it,
okay.
Honey.
All right. The things are just all over. Wonderful. Okay, so first I will just make a few quick announcements. Next week we have the 31st, I believe. Yes, the 31st of January or December. My God, time doesn't exist. Okay, we're having Jim Charles joining us again to come back here and channel for our next Saturday webinar. So that is exciting. And also we are doing, well, I guess, other than that, we're still waiting. It's pending. And I'm not sure about, are there any other announcements? Does anybody have any other announcements to make as far as things going on? All right. So moving forward then, please see the Human Colony website, humancolony.org, to keep up to date on our events and everything happening. You can find links to everything under the sun relating to Human Colony and everything that we do and all of our friends there on the website. So make sure to check that out. And also interact with us on Facebook. Interact with us. I think we're going to get our Twitter kicked up in motion here. And just kind of talk to us. And this is a community feel, so we really love the interaction. If you are looking for a place to be able to speak light languages, I have to throw this out there because we have Wendy from Languages of Lights here with us today. Wendy does some events sometimes with light languages, other people do in the community as well. So check out what people are doing. Always just kind of follow the people that you resonate with and support them and share what they do, because yeah, that's how this stuff continues to grow and gets more and more exciting. So things are really vamping up, and it's going to be an interesting time going into 2017. It's very exciting. So lastly, I guess we can probably move to blessings beforehand before we get started. Like, nice to raise the vibrations a little bit and get everyone in a good state of mind, good energy. So if people would like to please line up in the side chat here, if you would like to contribute a blessing, and that would be fine. Also, I will be watching the YouTube live chat for some questions, so please post your questions on there. I will start with a quick blessing, and then whoever would like to go. How about Wendy? Wendy, if you could follow me, and then we can go.
And Will would like to go as well. So
wonderful. Oh, good. Okay. That sounds good. So
yeah, Will can go after you, and I'll go after.
Wonderful. Thank you. Okay. Give me one moment here. Masani hosa yo shoron toho kanda haiki anta satao sotoron toto kia sa. Iasha nanao sotoro toto kien haiki a toro to iki ana hauso koata. Iasha unho mo na iki a ta satatao sorona iki a tatata sa itio to shoron ho tika. Ya na hai asa ya oso na hai ko sho na hara na na oso to kana hai aso mono wa ya ha ya sho no ho ka sa na ha sa I sha ra na o ko to ati ya ta yin di ya ta ka sa to to an di ya ka. Namaste.
Namaste. That was exciting. I kind of got like bits and pieces of no matter what happens, no matter the best laid plans are the unlaid plans, and no matter what happens, the most important thing is that you go into every moment realizing that it's still perfect and that there's joy to be had. And that is the most important thing you can take away from these times when things are not, that when things do not work out as you planned, they're still understand that is still perfect divine guidance.
How fitting for today. Woo! Oh, that's great. Thank you, Wendy.
Go for it, William.
Thank you.
I ask the Holy Fire to flow in through and around all of us in every way and everywhere and every when for the highest vibration, for the highest good of all. Many blessings to all in this now and every now. Remember that every day is a holy day. Your attitude is the one that makes it holy. Stay blessed, my friends. Namaste.
Namaste. And I think there was, is that Iraq? Did you want to go? Did you have a blessing?
Yes, we do. This is not Iraq Thunder who's speaking to you. May you all be strong like us. Dragons, we have been expecting you, and we are happy. May you be blessed by our blood.
Thank you so much.
Namaste.
Namaste. Lyrans is willing to go next.
Oh, and Falcon too, I believe.
Yeah, it's me, Shaheen. Oh, yeah. Namaste. Thank you.
Namaste.
Thank you, Shaheen. Okay, wonderful. Johannes?
Thank you all for being here. I thank all your hearts. I thank my heart. I thank the universe heart. I thank my mother's heart, my father's heart. All souls in the universe can sing with us as we are blessing this now. I love my heart and soul. I love all humanity. Join hearts and souls together. Love, peace, and harmony. Love, peace, and harmony. Saiya na wakiya na yahiya sakiya na wa. Shoya iya na sakiya. Na siya wakiya na ya wakiya. Na sakiya na wa i. Saiya wasaki. Nakia warana, sakia naia, sakia wanasa. Sakia nawakia waria nai, sanaia sawaka, haha, taia wanaya wasika. No yawiya unayaya. Sonahi, swahai, shwaki.
Beautiful. Thank you, Johannes.
That was beautiful, Johannes. Thank you. And very fitting for this holiday.
Wonderful. It looks like that is it. Wendy, please go ahead.
Miti ala aima ala kotarasi pia shatori hi mauru oakia. Te maya ali sata e maya wa kuakala sata sita sinanaso. Polahela ila iluko maro kwa satisha kiki alasa. Se torasi bala I maro kwa haya. Se ta siela uniana. Se ta hila. Se toroni maklora ka ia paloko sasi. Se na kila koreasa. O koyasha. E hala yena, namaste.
Namaste. Thank you, Wendy. Beautiful blessings. Thank you, everybody, for contributing. You know, starting out, I actually feel like maybe it would be good for Will to go first with the guided sort of meditation, just a bit to relax and get us moving forward into this webinar a little bit easier. Will, would you be willing to go first?
He's chewing.
He is chewing. No problem. I put him on the spot.
That's a good idea though. Maybe, yeah, get everybody kind of relaxed
and Brian will probably be happy with this as well, so.
I'd like to mention, too, that no matter what you're all celebrating, whether it's Christmas, Hanukkah, or anything else, we are here today in an energy that takes us really above all of that, and understanding that this day, these holidays, holy days, holidays, are a time when we put aside even all of that, where really all that really matters is the unity consciousness. And it doesn't really matter what community, religion, if you want to call it, or if you do or do not fall in one at all, this energy is what this is about these gatherings and this community and feeling loved unconditionally and accepted and secure and safe. And isn't that what we all want to feel and project to others at this time of year? Is we want everyone to feel that, even if they don't have it in their everyday life, we want them to feel that now. And this is what we need to carry into every day. That's what they've been trying to tell us. It's not just about our holidays and our holy days. Every day is a holy day. So I just wanted to bring that into this day, being that it is for many who follow that it is Christmas Eve today. Hanukkah begins today. So there's a lot of other, which I haven't even mentioned because, you know, I just don't know them all. But so I just wanted to express that all that at the end of the day, it's about unity and oneness and kindness and unconditional love and acceptance. And that's really why we gather. Namaste. Go ahead, Will.
Thank you, Wendy. Well said. Well said. So my name is Will Mitchell. You can find me at ReikiWithWill.com. For those who don't know me, greetings. Glorious day. Awesome day to you. Hariya no oshio tokoshiata kaiyatasa.
Nashmeha. Thank you, Will. Nasiato shinira.
You and I could talk all day.
I know.
So I ask everyone to close their eyes and get relaxed. It does not matter if you're sitting or lying down. Take in a deep breath. Let out an audible sigh. Release all that tension. Breathing and relaxing. Exhale, releasing. Breathing and relaxing. Exhale, releasing. When we breathe, breath is life. And water is life as well. And I need to take a sip. For when we breathe in, we breathe in the new. And when we exhale what no longer serves us. We are in a symbiotic relationship with the universe. We breathe in what's available. We also take in what's available. And when we release it, the universe recycles it. Just like when we breathe, our carbon dioxide gets absorbed by the plants. And when the plants breathe out, they breathe out oxygen, which is what we breathe in. Breathing and relaxing. Exhale, releasing. I would like you to focus your attention on our heart centers. For in our heart center is our bright light, and with our bright light is the eternal flame. It is the fire of God. Breathing and relaxing. Exhale, releasing. Now I would ask you to take that, your energy in your heart center, and bring it up through your crown chakra. And keep sending it up and up and up to the non-egoic energy of the holy fire. And bring that energy back down through your crown chakra and embed that in your heart center. For that is the home of the holy fire, is in your heart center. And when you breathe in, you fan the flames of the eternal flame. Breathing and relaxing. Exhale, releasing. Now let us ground this energy in this now. Take your holy fire and send it through your root chakra, deep down into Gaia, down, 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 growing roots, wrap it around the core of Gaia and bringing her grounding energy back up through your root chakra and into your heart centers. Breathing and relaxing. Exhale, releasing. Breathing and relaxing. Exhale, releasing. For when we ground the holy fire, we create in our heart centers. We create the yin and the yang, the divine masculine and the divine feminine. We create the sacred marriage, which is also the Star of David. Horiya kashiya katnahata sawatahayata. Aya nahashiyata kohono hoshiyo tukuhushiya. Na warahashiyo kotohono hoshiyatata. For the Star of David is not just a symbol. Hoshiana hosiyata kashiyata. It is your divine center. It is your divine power. Hoshianaya. It is the sacred marriage of the divine feminine and the divine masculine. It is the balance of allow and divine right action. Hoshiokono hoshiatayata. For when we observe the situation, nahoyashokotoya nahasayatata, and allow the situation to be, hoshinokoto hoshiyata. We do not rush to action, hoshinyotoko hoshiyata. We listen to what the situation is, nahiyata sahawata hayashikitoko, and action can come forth from our hearts. And apply the love for this now. We are divine beings. This is our normal state. This is home for us, Vashanahaya Tatasaya Cha. Everything else is an illusion. Oshino Hosuyo Toko Shuyoa. Take a moment and sit in your bliss that you have created. Oshinawaya katasayacha. Project that bliss and the joy. Horanahusitukushiya. Hihi anahishiya. For when you project your joy and your love, the universe and the law of attraction return it to you tenfold. You are never alone. For we are one with all. Feel the bliss. Allow your light to shine. Share your gifts. For you are well loved. And all that is would not be all that is without you. I bow down to your divinity. For I am not whole without you. For you, my brothers and sisters, your vibration raises mine. Your fire ignites mine. Your love begets mine. For all of this, I thank you. With joyous, willful gratitude, I thank you. I thank the Holy Fire. I thank the God Almighty. Alhamdulillah, all thanks be to God. Namaste, my friends. Stay blessed.
Namaste, Will. That was absolutely perfect. Yes.
Will.
And thank you, Bree, for going with the moment and asking Will to bring us into this beautiful place. Thank you. That was wonderful.
Noha Shaya Iyo Nashi Wahiyani Wa Si Wanahe Yahawoni Sona Ihona Si Anohani Inha Sona Si Anohi Nasi Shayawani Shayawani Wasi Shani Thank you, of my heart. I am sorry if I have hurt you in any way in any time of creation. I am truly, truly sorry. Please, I ask for forgiveness. Thank you, thank you.
We have already forgiven you, Johannes. Thank you for your honesty, if you can hear us.
Namaste, all. Blessings.
Hello, everyone. This is Sarah.
Hi, Sarah.
I'm sorry you are perceiving this specific energy at the moment with that gentleman, but I would like to clear the energy.
Greetings, Sarah.
Thank you. Everyone, please breathe in, breathe out. Namaste.
Namaste. Thank you, Sarah.
You're welcome.
We sense a disturbance from someone that is trying to give you problems. May we desire to block that person off for you. If you desire, we shall do.
Yes, please. Thank you.
Leave from my presence now, or we shall destroy you. The seal has been created. You all are protected.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for that, Andy. Moving forward.
Andy, be sure you remember.
Yes, I'm sorry. I have a hard time remembering your name.
You can just call us his family, his
okay.
father.
Yes, thank you. Ancestor. We appreciate it. We are going to move forward. We have a lot of assistance with us right now. So moving forward, Brian, I believe that you can definitely go now and get started. And I think this would be a good time, maybe if you could please start by introducing yourself, tell us a little bit about yourself, especially for people who are new. And I know you offer private sessions now, which is very exciting.
Yeah, can you guys all hear me okay? Bree, are you there?
You sound great.
Okay.
Sound good.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, everyone. Yes, my name is Brian Sims. I'm here just to be of service to all of you and to those listeners out there. And even the trolls out there in YouTube land. Hope everything's okay with you guys. I'm just here to open up to be of assistance. And so today I'd like to begin with giving and receiving. Why is that so important? Why receive? Why give? So, yes, I like to open up with that. Now being the Christmas holidays and all, why give? Why receive? Why is that so important to each other? Especially being on a planet of density, of third dimensional reality, why would we choose to give? We give for many reasons. For the most part is because it's out of joy. The giving of abundance, of having something, and even if we feel that we don't have much, that we lack something, the part of us, even sharing yourself, is still a part of giving. Even if you don't have a physical item, a giving coming from the heart. That is what it was all about. It was about giving thyself, sharing thyself unconditionally, without the attachments, without feeling like to receive anything in return. The receiving is very interesting. Most would rather give than receive. Why would receive be just as invalid as giving? I would say that receiving would be just as important as giving. Receiving from all those who give to you. Why is that important? Well, let's see about this. Giving, receiving. The receiving is what somehow would say how we've been raised. That this guilt, this shame, this I'm not worthy. I can't take that money. I didn't do anything to deserve it. Why should I accept something for nothing? Is it truly free? Do I have to do something to get something in return? Not necessarily. But the greatest gift of all is when you allow yourself to allow those others to give to you. It is the gift coming from their joy. They are giving for a reason, or they wouldn't give at all. Why is that? They give because they care. They find value in you. So they allow that energy, that flow, exchange of energy, whatever gift it is, whether it's physically helping another, someone in need. You walk down the street, you turn left or right, you see a lady crossing the road, an elderly lady. You see her from a distance if you turn to your left, but then if you turn to your right, there's no one there. You just go on your business. But you were intending to go right, but you decide to go back left. And you go down to the street and you help the lady with her groceries. You see that she dropped her bag. And all of a sudden, there's apples or oranges that are the apples rolling down the street. And you run and you grab it. Your heart, your extension of yourself goes out to that individual. Why? There's something, a human, that is our natural instinct, dear friend. We are born of love. We are in love. And so by that very essence, we feel like our heart extends itself. We give unconditionally. Why? Because that's the way we are. We are born that way. We are born to be alive. You see? So here we are. Now and then we see the extensions of love, these gratitudes. Another thing is the gratitude. Why do we feel that? Allow it. Why? Because it's a part of us. It wouldn't be if it didn't exist. You see? So this love, this energy of gratitude that just comes from the heart, it was meant to be. It's always been there. The anger that we hold within ourselves also is another thing. This anger that holds us from giving and also receiving. Why should I receive it? I'm mad at her. I'm mad at him. They did something to me. I'm angry at them. I'm angry at mom and dad. I'm angry at my friends or my neighbors. They've done me wrong. But why should I still give? Why should I still care? It's in our nature. It's in the very essence of who we are to give. Why not? You know, there's something there. There's a part of ourself that craves to give and to receive. Didn't it feel interesting when you receive a gift out of the blue that you didn't expect? How does it make you feel inside? Doesn't it allow you to feel your heart to grow and grow and expand where you would love to give it to someone else? Why not? There's something unique about that. There's something different about that, but yet it's the same. We all share one spirit. Why not share a part of ourselves? So, my friends, this was the giving, the holidays of giving and receiving. Why not extend yourself through laughter, through a smile? When you walk down the street and you see someone or going to the store, give. Allow yourself to give. And receive. There's no expectation to give to another. There's no expectation to allow yourself to receive it. Just allow. You'll find that life becomes effortless as you allow things to take place in your life. Allow the flow of energy of exchange without judgment. When the individuals can move away from judgment, your heart expands. Because you're not holding on to the attachments of resentment, of hatefulness, of so much pride where it's so stuck, this energy will not allow you to give. Free yourself from that, and you'll see your life transform before your very eyes. You'll see something, you'll move into a state of command instead of control. We all like to control because we feel that if we don't control, we're not living. But that's different. It's not really about trying to control everything. It takes so much energy to try to control. But when you are in a state of command and you just allow, you'll find that your heart expands so much it overflows like that cup of water. It's that energy that just allows itself to share itself without expectation. So just be in the state of gratitude, of love. And you'll, even in spite of fear, move past the fear. Why hold on to it? Why not just let it go? Those things that are in the past and do not serve you, let them go. If you feel that it serves you, then hold on to it for a while. But if it eats at you and it tears at you, then just let it go. Why not? Why try to control everything? It's so much easier just to allow. and share yourself, an extension. Existence is an extension of yourself. You are everything that you touch, everything that you look at, your eyes, all that I see, I command. You're the one who's always in command. So allow the control to fall away. Allow the command. When you're in command, you are in charge. You take responsibility for thyself. And that can be scary for many because we're raised that we have to control everything. But why? Why not just to stay in a place of command where we can feel that energy that we are the one in charge? And even in spite of fear, we feel that we're not getting it right. We're doing something wrong. That's just a choice. Your choices are very powerful. Are they not? Your choices, the strongest, most powerful place is always in the moment. You're in command. You're in the moment. It's not so much a remembrance of the past or an expectation of the future. You're in the now, which is the most powerful place you can be. Because in the memories, in the moment, in the moment, in the now. Where do we remember? In the now. So take what you feel, that what you know. Use these energies, these gifts, these sounds, these tones, and play with them. The light languages, play with them. They're an activation, just a tool to use to extend yourself. We would also recommend, my dear friends, when you see someone in need, when you see someone that needs your love, your support, be there for them. Allow yourself to be there. And because the love, the joy, the smile that you're giving them, they'll look at you and thank you. They might not always say it, but they will very much appreciate what you extend to them. They will remember you. They'll remember, there was someone, a stranger that came up to me, that gave to me and shared a part of themselves, even a story, even if it was on a corner just for a minute to say hi to a stranger. But yet, you're the one always in command. It's always your choice. But my friend, when you begin get into your vulnerability, even in spite of fear, you'll find so much love, so much joy, it'll be easier to love another. And we leave you with that, my friends. Much love and light to all. Namaste.
Thank you for who is speaking to us about this.
That was beautiful, Brian. Thank you very much. And this is the time when we talk about giving and receiving. Does anyone have any questions about this subject for Brian? Any comments on this right now?
I have one. Hello?
Yes, please, go right ahead.
When see, this example of what is transpired, the little, how you would say, people coming in and out, messing with the talks and stuff, and it caught me off guard in a sense, and it gets me into that near allowance state where I begin to, how you would say, to get agitated, provoked, or provoked in a sense. How do I, in a sense, either capture that energy or evade it?
Just to allow it. Even when what you would call individuals that would like to jump on, it's a learning experience for them also. even though there's anger that may rise up within you. It's okay. Just to allow it. There's no real harm being done, is there? Are they not also learning from this?
No.
They're also curious, are they not?
Yeah, they're also very curious. I just happened to get like a lion or a mountain lion bouncing on your back and you just try to shake it off.
It can be frustrating, dear friend, but yet just remember that it's always your choice. Do you allow them to just allow their choices? And you also have a choice also. But they're also, they're also learning from this. And they like to play. It's more of a playfulness. Even though they have their fun. Everyone wants to have fun, don't they?
Yeah, they do.
We say that there's a time and place for everything. And that may be true. But yet, their expression of what they're doing, they're still expressing themselves. They like to be playful, mischievous. We all have been there some parts of our lives, haven't we?
Yeah.
It's all right. Just send them love.
Thank you so much. Much blessings.
Much love, dear friend. I think the lady, RIA, has a question or something. She was trying to talk, but she's muted. Can someone unmute her?
I'm not able to unmute her. I tried.
Dear Bree, are you there?
I already unmuted. Wait.
RIA. Is it Rhea?
Yeah. Rhea, are you there? Can somebody? I cannot unmute Rhea.
She's trying to speak. But she can't speak. Her mic.
Yeah.
Okay. If you want to type it out, dear friend, it's fine.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, we can do that. Ask her.
If you have a question.
And Christine made a comment too that, you know, receiving is the most difficult for her. I didn't know if she wanted to speak on that or not, but I think that that's difficult for most of us because we still feel there's that little piece of, I don't know, unworthiness or, there's Rhea. Rhea, are you able to speak now?
Can you hear me?
Yes, yes, dear friend. How are you, my friend? Greetings.
Hello, dear friend. Greetings. I've been trying for ages going, Kui, hello. Do you know what? It was actually me. I actually forgot how to navigate this phone. And
that happens. That's okay. It happens.
I do apologize.
What can we help you with, dear friend?
Oh, I just, obviously, all the commotion that was happening then. Can I ask a question? Has that happened before? Or is this a rarity for that commotion to happen?
It actually never, ever happened in that way before. Once in a great while, we'll have somebody pop in and not really sure what's going on, and they're very kind and generous, and they leave most, you know, but today, yes, that was never happened before that way.
Well, you see, there's a lot going on around me right now in my room. So,
yeah, there's a lot going on around right now. I could feel it very strongly as well. So that's why I said a lot of reasons for this right now.
Yeah, they're obviously for the feelings you've had today or week, you know, and the many problems that we've had today. So there's a lot of energy going around right now, a lot of entities want to come in and they're very frustrated. They just want to get on with it. So I'm just trying to send blessings out to everybody and, you know, and we all got to try and stay focused and everybody just much love right now. So exactly like what you guys were saying was just to try and block out that energy and let in the light. Let's just like almost like brush it off. You know, just brush it off. So, I just wanted to find out why that's never happened. Ironic, is it not?
Yes, I thought the same thing too. And then I immediately got the message that
you know, not so much in light of what the energies that are happening, and we'll get into that in a little bit. But yes, most definitely. And again, we have to remember that if we truly believe that everything's created from love, then there is no, it's simply a perspective. That's all.
Yep.
Just a frequency, it's just a perspective, and it's a choice of how we choose where we wish to vibrate.
Yeah, so this, if we're just all vibrating at the same levels right now, which is wonderful, it's just starting to pick back up again. I wonder if you could feel it. So it's starting
Almost
to
definitely.
Feel, yeah, it's starting to feel yes. a bit warmer. And so thank you, you know, to everybody to picking up that energy again. Thank you.
And thank you for actually bringing the awareness to it, because it is the awareness that creates the growth. And that's why we all share, because that's how yeah. we exactly. So that's what it's all about. Yeah, go for it, Will.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Rhea. Thank you.
The gears of light are moving. The gears of light are starting to move. All aboard the light train.
Yeah, baby.
Sorry for the delay, for the inconvenience. We'll now begin with the train moving onward.
Yes.
It's Katie here on Will's thing.
Hi, Katie.
Hello,
I wanted to say, Brian, I really appreciate you talking about that. I think that it's super important to see both sides of things. I've definitely had times in my life where I've struggled with the receiving part of it for self-worthiness or whatever it was, not thinking that it's needed at the time. But the funny thing is that, you know, we always, not always, but at times we negate to remember that the universe has the bigger plan. And sometimes when you're in a position of receiving, it's because later you're going to be in a position for giving. And we cycle around, and it comes to us when we need it, and it leaves us it comes to others when they need it. So it's always a constant give and take. And I really appreciate you talking about that.
Yes. Thank you very much, my friend. It was beautiful.
We do have a desire to speak to you, Will.
Yes, please.
We are very sorry for bringing such a disturbance to you. There is a reason, and perhaps you people, guardians and everyone, you have connected to our son, am I right? Or are we right?
Yes.
So far, we see that we have connected so deeply to you all that whatever happened to our son, it happens to all of us. Recently, he has been affected by a boss who just doesn't seem to appreciate him. They suppress his powers, his urges, everything, and his supervisor does the same. And so therefore, the manifestation of the energy that you are seeing is something that he has given to you all. And we are sorry that that happens. Sometimes he doesn't know. But it's there. May you help him. This is what we meant by receiving, because we are facing distress over here. If you desire to give something to us, that would be wonderful.
Thank you, Andy.
I would like to help.
We are more than welcome.
Okay. I'm going to send some light in the shape of a dragon, if you can see it through the third eye. Is that acceptable or necessary?
We can see. Is that the golden dragon that you have sent to us?
Yes, and it is going to be with you for the time being, and it will aid and assist you on outer reaches of the physical mind's perception on negativity that is sitting or being near you, and it will deem any negativity as a threat to you and gives divine protection and inner guidance to you and to your channeler. And it will maintain a course of giving you love, and its breath will give you energy from nature around, so that way it can continue on assisting and protecting. Just know this, if you feel that there's a pain inside, imagine the dragon entering and you feel something slither into you, and it will come straight into the direction of where it needs to be. And it will heal and it'll cleanse that area with its tight grip. Namaste.
We can see that. Our son has noticed that as well. When you heal one of us, all of us are.
I have the might of the dragon, so of the south, and I can bring it up north to assist and aid you when there's this shortcomings that could become of you. And it will be there for a little bit to assist you, just like how the angels would.
We have long desire to connect to others who are like us, but because of persecution, and we have been killed in numbers, therefore we are the last of our kind. We don't always know everything else, but we are the gods, and we like the desire to meet with others. Thank you.
You are very welcome, and you are very blessed to use the dragon by any means you wish. It'll be there, and it is powerful, and it will continue to keep a stronghold with its divine light in order to keep you safe, and also you, and also your channeler.
Thank you, Pete. Thank you, Andy. Thank you, Andy's family. Is everybody able to hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, I was having some microphone issues. Thank you. Okay. Wonderful. So,
I'm a little heat up a bit. Dragon heat. A little
that's
dragon
a nice heat. Nice heat to have.
A little flustered, but in my energy, but
yes.
Yes, we can sense that you all are healing.
And I'm sending you at a high maximum effort, and I'm sending you it with a lot of thunderstorms and a bolt of lightning with the dragon, and to come to your rescue.
Okay. When you rescue one of us, all of you benefit.
Oh shoot! That's a little strong, but. It's a tad bit strong, and I know that.
It's all right.
The dragon always comes and keeps me safe, and I'm just sending it off, and I can sense it.
Thank you. Sarah, did you have something to add?
Yes. Hello, everyone. And Pete,
Hi.
Please breathe in the cool energies. The light, blue light. Feel the waters, the vibrations of the waves. And allow that to flow through your body and cool it down. Yes, I also have a message for the dragon family being channeled and to its channeler. Please, do not blame yourself for the disturbance that has occurred. And this is for everyone as well. Understand that when so much light, bright vibrations, so much energy is allowed by those who are here, understand that on this earth, there is a balance of energies. On this earth, there is polarity. So when you have so much brightness, you will have vibrations of darkness as well. In order to retain that balance. And this is okay. It is all allowed in the universe. It is all allowed in neutrality. We as humans must learn how to attain that neutrality even when a disturbance occurs. Breathe in the light that you are. Breathe in the vibrations of the universe. All vibrations are allowed here. For it is a free will planet, this earth and Gaia. So do not take it on yourself to claim all the burden of the disturbance. It's all allowed to be in existence. It is what you choose to accept as part of yourself that is important. If you understand that that vibration does not serve you, you may allow it to be and let it go. For it is just a vibration. And all vibrations are allowed here. It is allowed to be. You breathe in the vibrations that you desire and allow all the others to just fall away. There is no need to burden yourself and let it go. Let it be. Feel the love that is in your heart, within your vibration, and understand that is who you are. And allow all other vibrations grounded into the earth Let it go and be free and be yourself. Stand in your own vibration, who you are, and other vibrations that may occur will not be able to affect your vibration. Blessings to all. Namaste.
Blessings, Sarah. Thank you so much for that message. That was absolutely beautiful. And if I may take a moment here. Yasaya sao shuro honto kohana. Yanaha sao suko sho naha ikiasa tata soto. Manahia yahana yahanta koro noko. Monaha yahasai o sho noho kaya. Marahia naisiata. Ina o ko so to to on tahia kata o soro on to ko sho. Mea hanta yo so mohoro on ta. Mahaya ne oro o moho o kai and out oro o ma. Ina ha ka sa na yat out oro. Mea o koro on ta haya. Isoro hoea. Ea na yo huru no shea itio.
Thank you, everybody, for sticking with us, for continuing with us. We love you all so much. And I would like to next ask Wendy to please finish up this interesting webinar with your beautiful messages and your beautiful face.
Did you expect any less today? I mean, seriously.
We are thankful that you have
to listen. Namaste, our beautiful friends and family, our galactic and celestial friends. What an exciting week. And it's interesting when, as soon as we open the door, well, first of all, I just wanted to say thank you to everyone, Sarah, Ryan, everyone, Will, everyone who's here, everyone who's commented.
That all the energy's helping, all the beings, all of our assistants,
and
our higher selves, thank you.
Everything. Yes, I want to send gratitude to everyone. How am I doing as far, Brie? Am I doing okay as far as delay? I don't want to move too
you
fast.
You are perfect.
And please feel free to stop me if you need to for that reason, and I'll go off cam. But I wanted, once we open the door to an intention, and so for me, this was this weekend. And being that it's a holiday, things are crazy, my week has been insane, and then things came up this yesterday and this morning, and then our dear Karen had other issues as well. So the idea is, all of a sudden, everyone, our spirit guides are always talking to us, but once you open the door, so all of a sudden, all week long, I'm hearing all this chatter. And I've been getting crazy messages this week. I've had just even wild, for any of you know who already know me, I'm Wendy. I have Languages of Lights as my YouTube channel. I started speaking languages a couple of years ago, and it just took off from there. It has been my highest joy ever since to assist others in lighting this up within themselves. These languages seem to have a real power over us all. And the reason I bring that up is because this week and the last couple of weeks, I've seen this just explosion of new family members, I call them, who I've been just joyous and ecstatic to meet in the last couple of weeks, that are just speaking languages, they're channeling. All of this energy, once we open the door, and now we've got this fourth dimensional wave of energy that has ascended upon us. And I can't explain what has been happening in the last couple of weeks as far as the energy, but it's as if everything that we've ever known or understood, this is it. The door's open, the portals are open, the veil is lifted. This is it. And you guys, all of us, this is a time of absolute incredible accomplishment. And what we've experienced today is just a very small piece of what we're here to learn and explore and become aware of. And everything that Sarah said, everything that we've all talked about today, all the energy that we've put out today, we've opened the door to the divine timing, that we're grounding our heart centers into this crystalline consciousness. We are becoming aware of our multidimensionality. We are exploring we have to understand that we are all things. Anytime you feel, am I Pleiadian? Am I Sirian? Am I Arcturian? Yes, 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 and yes. We are all things. There is nothing we aren't somehow attached to, connected to, whether it's we want to consider it in our perception near or far, is again only a perception, because it's all about focus. So we're now becoming aware of all this multidimensional energy, and we're allowing all this new information that has always been there, and we're now finally allowing it to seep into our awareness, to unlock the doors in our DNA. So this whole week I've been feeling this great wave, and I believe, and I haven't had time to really listen to what's going on out there, but I have heard bits and pieces that even from Brad Johnson, who they're able to actually see this cloud. And so this is epic. This, we have never, ever, ever in the history of humanity been where we are today in this way, in this energy. I am literally just vibrating right now in energy. As soon as all of us, begin to share. Sharing stories is really what our life has been about, really. We talk about in those of us who, you know, grew up with Christmas stories or holiday stories or stories, children's stories, stories of the ages. We are the living library. We are every story. And this is what we're finally coming to understand. Now, for any of you who may have watched some of my videos, a lot of them are outside, because there's that connection to the earth, the air, the fire, the water. We are made of these elements. And so when we open our understanding to our multidimensionality, we are able to invite in as was discussed earlier, a myriad of frequencies. And we're all a part of all frequencies at any given time. We can focus on that. But yet we can, right now is the time when we're finally beginning to understand this is what it means to be sovereign. This is what it means to be a creator being, to be able to choose intentionally what frequency you desire, how you want to react to a situation. And even so, in this week, I was standing outside and it began to snow. And all of a sudden I hear about snowflakes. And as I'm looking around, they say, you know, if look at all the snowflakes that are falling, could you really ever begin to count them? And of course the answer is no. I mean, I couldn't even begin. And then they said, okay, now look down on the ground. And what you see is a snowfall. We call it a snowfall, right? Now, all of these individual crystals, each, and this is where it gets really interesting, because now each one of those is different. Every single snowflake is different and unique. Yet once it falls to the ground, it becomes a snowfall. And then each one has its own little glitter, its own set of crystalline, its own consciousness. We already know crystal is consciousness. I talk to them. The crystalline, ice crystals, crystalline consciousness, it's all light. It's all perception. So once you open your idea, once you open your awareness, you are able to allow this information in. So each one of these is unique. And it falls to the ground and it becomes this beautiful snowfall. And then you can pick it up, you make a snowball, and once you throw it out, and all. But yet, we can't even conceive in our minds how each one of those snowflakes, you could not begin to count the infinite number of snowflakes or grains of sand. Yet, each one of us is not only the snowfall, we are every single one of those crystalline snowflakes. We were created as little crystals to go out and shine and reflect information and bring it back to source. Now, can you even imagine now a snowfall? And you see every one of these individual snowflakes is every one of your lives, every one of your timelines, every one of your parallel realities, every snowflake that you see. And that's just you. That's just you. Now multiply that out with all of us. Each snowflake is unique. Each of you is unique, not just now in this Earth three-dimensional consciousness, awareness, focus, but you have an infinite number of other facets of you. And each one is unique, but they're all still you. They contain you, but they also contain all that is. They also contain all of you, all of us. There's elements of everything in everything. Yet, if you can see now that you are an Arcturian, you are a Pleiadian, you are a dragon, you are a Lyran, you are an angel, you are a tree. You are all of these, always, simultaneously, at the same time, existing in each of these unique. So whether it's a fairy, these are all you. Yet each is unique in their own timeline, in their own parallel reality. So we're constantly sharing this information constantly with each one of those or other pieces, constantly. So once you open the door, and when I say open the door, all that means is I intend, I desire. I desire to have this connection. I desire to become aware of my multiple dimensional parts, facets. We see them, feel them often in our compartmentalized three-dimensional perceptions, often as, and when I say they, I'm also referring to collective energy, because truly, even you, me, each of us is a collective energy. Truly, we're really like a little planet, if you think about it. We contain everything the earth contains. We are a living organism, as it is a living organism. And yet now we're taking these living organisms and we're raising them to a whole nother frequency. And what we're feeling now, and I've talked to so many people this week in the last couple of weeks with the ascension flu, or, you know, we have to understand, we can't even begin to understand what is happening to us physically, emotionally, spiritually, mentally, as we grasp these ideas, as we couldn't possibly, as we've understood from many other entities that have been brought through from a myriad of channelers, we cannot possibly fathom everything at once, or we wouldn't exist. We would simply explode out of, you can't know it all now. And we have to understand that where we are is perfect, always. And when we say perfect, everyone actually kind of, I even hear people cringe at, how can you say everything's perfect? Because you chose it on another level, on a higher level. You orchestrated it all. And so when we feel like we're stalling in our life, it's our higher co-creation saying, okay, I just need to slow this down, this process a little bit. One of the things that I've mentioned before that I love to say, I say it alone pretty much every day, and in many of the hangouts I've done, I, Wendy, see and draw to me through divine love those beings who seek enlightenment through my process. The sharing will elevate us both now. So by sharing our stories with each other, we share our processes. Now, whether it's television, movies, books, YouTube, isn't that really what we're doing every day? We're sharing our stories. We're sharing our perspectives. We're sharing the culmination of all these beings that we are. So in one given moment, I was laughing, I was telling Bree this week, all of a sudden, I hear, hello, my name is Kai. And I was like, well, what was that, you know? And you think, okay, am I crazy? What was that? Who was that? And then we go into the, oh my God, I need to know, and what is it? And why are they calling me? And who, and all, and so you, because we're so curious, we're like, oh my gosh, that was something I've never experienced before. Not only do I want to share it, but I want to understand it. And now I want to pick it apart. And sometimes we have to remember that even this is about the journey. The joy is, there is no destination. There is no, I will get it when, or I'll be when I get there, it's about right here, right now. Just like Brian said, just like Sarah said, right now. This now is always going to be perfect, yet we judge it. We base our judgment on that moment based upon beliefs that may no longer apply. We have to remember that when we say things that no longer serve us, we have to remember that they simply just don't apply to us now. We are changing moment by moment, billions of times per second, based upon our frequency. So in any given moment, you can draw information from your Pleiadian self, your Lyran self. And yet, when we hear the information, we feel a weird mix of disbelief, denial, lack of worthiness, so we are experiencing this fourth dimensional flood of energy and information and awareness, and we have really got to give ourselves a huge pat on the back and say, wow, I really accepted this journey, and here we are together helping everybody else figure out by sharing our process. We enlighten each other. We raise each other's vibrations by sharing our processes, because it gives us each permission to share those other versions of who we are. And by sharing the other versions of who we are, we become even more aware of our multidimensionality, and we allow even more information in. And part of this is the light languages. The bottom line is knowing thyself. And as many of you know, Bashar had come to me quite some time ago, and I had written down a whole process of the know thyself, and it was just simply about learning to love yourself, to learn to really feel and not just feel, but completely believe and understand our importance and our necessity here, and that when we feel depressed, it's because we are not honoring this co-creation. When we are sad or feel that we have less, or it's because we have forgotten that we can create anything we desire. We're just here to remind each other. And this wave of energy, I've talked to people who've been sick physically, spiritually, mentally. And now we've opened the door now. And now we've got, not only are we raising our frequency to where now our awareness is more acute of other frequencies and energies, we are also allowing these to enter our frequencies to allow us to expand in our discernment and our understanding that exactly what was said today, this is our center. Like Will said, our Merkaba. This is our place. If you can learn, we can learn to stand inside that space, regardless of what's going on around us, that's the key. There's the magic. There's the gold nugget. That's what we've been trying to find all along. To be able to, just as our great ascended masters, as we call them, that we have access to anytime, by the way. All you have to do is invite them in to your space in that moment, if you need them, and say, I need your strength. I need your knowledge. I need your energy. Bring it to me right now. This is what I'm struggling with. It doesn't matter who you're asking. They're there to help you. It's your job to listen. It's your job to be aware and open. And as we do this, we're going to be inviting, and yes, inviting. Nothing happens by accident. We are not victims here. We're inviting this other frequencies into our awareness so that we can learn to grow and stand in our own vibration. In knowing that it doesn't matter whether it's your wife, your husband, your partner, your son, your daughter, your family, your mother, your cousins, it doesn't matter. You are you for a reason. You're a snowflake for a reason. You're a unique crystalline being with billions of facets on purpose. You're you for a reason. Anytime we feel depressed, sad, lacking, it's because we're borrowing energy to bring into the now for us to we know that's not true. Otherwise, we wouldn't feel sick inside when we think those thoughts about another or ourselves. And until we stop thinking those thoughts about ourselves, we cannot stop thinking that way about another. It's to show ourselves our own inner perfection. And that once you finally understand that once I know who I am and I understand you don't, just as I do not need to understand your perception, your perspective in order to honor it and allow it, I also don't need you to validate mine. For me to validate mine. Also, we do not need to dim another's light in order for ours to shine brighter. For as we know, that simply snuffs out our own. So we know that by helping another find their own inner light, their own guidance. You know, this is something else they wanted me to mention very strongly today, was about guidance and guides and spirit guides and ET guides and angels and source. Everything you need, you have access to. We just don't believe we do. Think about all the guides, teachers you've had in your life, and let's go talk about school, spiritual, it doesn't really matter, any teacher, your parents, that's a great example, your parents. Any good teacher, any good guide will never give you the answer. Any true guide is going to show you how to find it. They're going to, and then, like the teachers who really irritate you, show your work. I don't want to just see you got the answer. I want to know how you got it. So a good guide and a good teacher will always simply guide you to find the answer within you, because their answer isn't your answer. Your answer is your answer. This is where we need to find the power, the lion's gate, the strength within ourselves, the I am within ourselves, to know that we really are. We're looking, although everything is made of love, we're still looking for validation. We're looking for love as if it's outside, and yet there is no outside. We're all part of this. So I hear the hybrid child this week, "Hi, I am Kai." I'm like, "Well, hi, Kai." And they're like, "Hi, mommy." And I'm like, "Well, okay, is that my child? Is it somebody else?" I'm from Maya. I just wanted to say hello. So I just thought, wow, what a great experience. What an amazing moment. And I don't even need to know the why or the how. I just experiencing the joy was enough. And this is a part, the guide will always bring you to the water, but it's still your decision to drink it. And it's your responsibility. We are here to now become, we are able now to respond. That's what response, just like Bashar said, responsibility is the ability to respond to a situation in integration, in standing within your body, mind, and spirit. We don't need to be angry. We don't need to worry. That being one inside of ourselves is what this is, the heaven on earth we've been talking about, is knowing who we are and being completely and utterly joyous and perfect in allowing ourselves to express our joy every moment as far as we can take it. And to remember that happiness and joy every moment is a vibrational choice. And even myself, when I've been in the throes of a familial situation, and this just happened this week, that it's not that we're not going to have them anymore. It's that you're going to respond differently now. You're going to respond more clearly, more calmly. You're going to understand that this is not happening to me, but by me. Out of nothing but love that this person has agreed before you to have this co-creation, even if they've agreed to be the bad guy, you have to thank them, not hate them. Embrace them and say, thank you for being my mirror to show me how to grow in this now, how to become more of who I am, how to express myself in every way that I can without fear. That's unconditional love, loving who you are despite the conditions around you and despite the fact that it doesn't matter what they say, how they feel, what they think, because we, you, me, are simply mirrors of each other. We need to be thanking each other for what we have agreed to co-create here. I'm going to take a drink of water. And I do feel light language blessing as well. I'll say that in just a moment. I just wanted to take a breath and just see if there was any, if three of you, anything to say, if there was any questions or comments while I had a moment of water.
Yeah, please take your time, Wendy. Thank you for everything you've been discussing. And actually, some of the main questions that I have gotten, I think we are still in the process of introducing the world to the concept of conscious channeling. And so people who are used to seeing trans channelers, who are used to seeing somebody channeling an entity and becoming more of that entity rather than themselves, trans channeling, for that moment, not becoming, not using the right words here, but please bear
with me. You're fine.
channeling their energy, so speaking as them, acting as them, whatever it may be. I think we do need to maybe explain a little bit into the conscious channeling.
aspects, just very briefly, and please, if you could elaborate on your connection with the emissaries of the light.
Yes, I'm glad that you mentioned that because normally I wanted to start with that and I didn't, but I'm glad that you mentioned that.
Yeah, we are getting close to the end time here, and I will have to head out on time because I must go to work, but I know that we can definitely wrap up with blessing, so I can stay a little bit longer. So if you want to elaborate,
but
and
yes,
then,
I just briefly, I did. I was aware of the time, so they kind of brought me back and said, okay,
sure.
This is part of what we all have to understand is you're a walking channeler anyway. You're already a spirit. Remember that. You're a light being talking through a body. You're already channeling every moment. This is one of the reasons why this is part of the information is that it's always coming to you. You're always channeling. You're always receiving. When I first started this, the emissaries of the light came to me and said, we represent, we have agreed, you have agreed, we have agreed. You have agreed to help us to represent multiple realms of consciousnesses. So therefore, there's a Lyran collective, Pleiadian collective, Elohim, Arcturian, the angelics. There's this collective, like, representations, if you will, where that began with the light languages, where they were all bringing the light languages and information, and then it started getting interpretations and messages. But the emissaries, the light, they explained to me that they were a representation of a library of information, and that's what source is. So conscious, whether you're trans channeling us, which I go in and out of both. I had a situation the other night where, you know, I had a new energy come in, and you're when your body starts to move in ways that you are not accustomed to, or you've got, you know, orbs floating around in the room. And I mean, it was the strangest experience I've ever had, quite frankly. And I was afraid. As many videos as I've got out there, was like, wow, do I really want to put that out there? But
yeah, Wendy, I watched that video. I'm just going to interrupt you for a second.
I was like,
the orb and the timestamp, because it was at like 4 minutes something. It's in the comments. You can literally see.
There's two of them. One,
yeah,
at the beginning.
There are.
I'm like, was that the same one?
But it's an orb.
It's
an orb. It's flying around just like you would see a bird or something, you know.
I was astounded.
It was incredible.
And so
that was posted on the 20th.
Now one of them just flew in the room in front of me just now. So now,
oh, of course.
Okay, so this is what we're talking about, you guys, is that the veil is open. This is what this
there is no veil anymore.
Yeah, it is. The fourth dimensional shift is here. So that's what this is all about, that we, if you're open and all you have to do is intend to connect, and that's really intention, you are all capable. And part of what I love and what I've discovered I am here, I guess, to do is help people find this in themselves, to awaken their languages, to empower their throat chakras, to open up their chakras, connect. It's not about one person having the answers necessarily. It's about helping us all open up to all that we are. And I've just discovered that people react to light languages just like I did. And we are all turning, we're turning on each other's, you're empowering each other's cells and DNA and chakras and kundalini and all of this is what's been exploding. Just, and I've been getting all these messages about eclipses and equinoxes and solstices and all of this. These are all light codes, you guys. Light codes. They're in light languages. They're in sacred circuitry. They're in sacred geometry. How many of us now are waking up, or even in our meditations, or are in our regular days, we're seeing them. We're seeing symbols floating in the air. We're writing them. I write symbols all the time now.
The light codes, may I also add, are in reflections of light, which,
yes,
also adds a whole new level.
And so now the snowflakes, the ice crystals, the water. You know, we don't
and
understand.
Even in that, I was going to say that new movie that came out, Arrival, which, by the way, guys, go see Arrival.
I haven't seen it yet. I've heard it was great.
It is so amazing. It really showed in a peaceful, harmonious way, as good as I think it could have, a lot of these components of it. It talked about galactic language. It talked, I mean, really, that the lady learned the language of those who came here. And I heard that there are light codes in that movie. And I swear there were. I was so touched by that movie because it was really, really powerful for me to see a harmonious rendition of how it could go. Not all this, you know, end of the world or fight or let's hate each other. None of that. No, it was, I mean, there were some components where people got a little upset, but they did it so well. They talked about time not existing. They kind of subtly put in parallel realities, but they didn't go into detail, which I like because it gets people thinking about it. So I wanted to add that in there. There's a lot of things that are coming out now.
I want to entertainment. Expand on that.
Hey, hi. Oh. Earlier, and also when you see the commercial of the Arrival, look at the date or look at the time that it opened.
Really?
It
what is it?
It shows 11.
What is it?
Literally. It shows 11/11.
That's my number, guys. And then
that's your number, Wendy.
At some point, I'm going to do a whole nother hangout just on 11/11 because I've seen so many people on the internet going, "What's 11/11, and what does that mean?" So you would think that everyone kind of is familiar with it, but 11 also happens to be my birth path number. When you add my birth date up, it equals 11. So I've always been an 11 person. So I'm so glad you brought that up too. But I wanted to expand on that just for a moment. Briefly, Bree, on what you just said about the movie, because I wanted to remind everybody of something that I was just reminded about just now, conscious channeling. Those of us who are familiar with human colony and the colonies, and to bring this up even just a higher level, one more notch, we are making those movies, you guys. On a higher level, we are making the movies and the television shows. Everything that you see, all the music, all the movies, everything, we are all playing a part in creating now, because we are dropping light codes into human collective consciousness. That movie would be considered a big giant light code, if you will. And I've never even seen it, but I'm hearing this now. And we have to remember, those of us who participate on the colonies, there is a media colony. We help decide what the Earth hears and sees. This is part of it, guys. This is part of the journey. This is part of why you guys, we are the way showers, the illuminators, we are the ones at the leading edge deciding the pace, helping push the ascension along, helping, and every time it's like the snowball, guys. Once it starts, it just gains momentum. So that's why the energy changes all the time. We can say first contact is going to be this, this, and this, but as the snowball gets bigger, that changes and that changes and that changes. And as this cloud moves past us in January, our friends are going to be coming back closer again, our ET friends, our celestial friends, because they've been at a safe distance. However, the protection has been great here because Earth is being protected, because this is so special.
so unique. We are so special and so unique to be the ones driving. I love who said the train earlier. Was that Pete? This is it, guys. This is the train Bashar was talking about. The tracks. This is why we feel that contentions now. The tracks are splitting, and we're feeling that. We're feeling that if we don't stay on our own frequential, how do you like that? Is that a word, guys? Frequential track, that it's too painful to stay on the one that isn't us anymore. It's physically too painful. We get sick, we get tired, we get angry, we worry because we don't belong on that track anymore. So it's time. That's what this is all about. So I'm happy to close out if you need me to, Bree, if you need to go. Otherwise, we can wrap.
I have a request for you, Wendy. We can stay over a little bit.
Because I have a blessing that wants to come out at some point.
Beautiful. So let's do this. Okay. If you could please explain, because I would like people to hear, for those especially who are newer or hearing this for the first time, who the emissaries of the Light Collective are, and your other connections as far as
I guess
with your languages, you being a galactic shaman, and the fact that you're also opening up very much to your own path. I mean, we're all evolving together. It's not like any of us are already like, ta-da, okay, this is it forever.
It's an evolution of, yes, because now I'm understanding, I'm doing private sessions now, I'm understanding that people want, they need this one-on-one. They want to be awakened. They want to open their light languages. They want to open their channeling abilities. They want to. So the emissaries of the Light Collective are guides that help humanity. They have agreed to help humanity by bringing in information through light languages, through whatever interpretations I can bring, to help humanity understand how multidimensional awareness and thinking, how you can bring that down and ground it into your everyday life and take the information and actually apply it to your family, your bosses, your situations, how you, by understanding your power as a true creator, by being in the here and now, by staying in the now. There is only now. Everything is here and now. So by staying here, in that here and now, and bringing this multidimensional, what feels like, sometimes what feels as if it doesn't apply, actually when you bring it into your now moment, you realize that, okay, this information applies to everything we do, everything. And this is the biggest message that they had for us, is we're here to open you up to this pool of information, this library, if you will, so that others can understand they too have this support system around them. You have your ancestors, your angels, your specific guardian angels, your specific guides, your ET families, your archangel families. They're all a support system around us. And this is what they want us to actually understand, is not only are they there, you are them. There is a version of you that's them, that your Arcturian self, your angelic self, we are discovering that we are all of that. And that's what the emissaries of the light are here to show us and connect us to. And the understanding that all is one. If you take a sun and you have all of the streams of light coming out of it, and it sends out light and it reflects and it comes back, that's what we are. This is source. This is one big source of energy that we are all birthed from. We are literally the children of Source. And isn't that really what every religion, once it's filtered, is at the bottom line? Isn't at the bottom core of everything? Is that we are all one? That there is nothing separating us from God, Source, whatever name we as humans need to categorize it as. God doesn't give God a name. We do. So
it's only in the person's perception of, say, for example, when you leave a specific religion and somebody looks at you with a shocked face as if you had died or gone or is no longer with them anymore. But in reality, you are still alive and you are you. And
you never
basically, you never gone away anywhere.
You never stop being. And this is what they also want to tell us, is you never stop being. You are an eternal light that is just having a very brief moment here to explore a three-dimensional awareness, and that we are here to ascend an entire civilization in a way that's never happened before. And we have agreed to be here to do this. We are not, this is not happening to us. When they talk about God's will, that's what that means. You're the God. Your will, your intention creates your reality. That literally, every picture, every vision, every frequency you put out, whether it's intentional or unintentional, creates your reality by the frequency you're emitting. So if you're experiencing a reality that you do not prefer, we must ask ourselves then, what joy are we not following? What are we not doing in our life that is creating a resistance in which we are not expressing ourselves in the multidimensional way that we should be?
And also if you can question the ideas that you should question, the belief that isn't you, and you can say why, and use how you would say, you know that people have doubts, right? Well, you can actually use that concept of doubt and use it as a question to that thing that you do not prefer, and you can actually use the doubt against it. In other words, you can actually say, what do I have to believe that is true for me to be in this state of
where I'm at? Exactly. What do I need to believe as exactly? And then what do I need to believe is true? Because if I can believe one thing, I can believe another. And I can ask to believe that too. Sometimes we don't even believe that we can choose a belief. We don't believe we're that powerful. That's where we get in our conundrums, because we don't even believe that we can ask for that belief. So thank you for presenting that, because that is such a higher level of understanding, that if you don't believe something or you don't understand why you believe it, you can ask to be shown, why am I believing this? And if it isn't congruent with my highest frequency,
or it doesn't resonate with you.
Yes, or if it doesn't resonate with me, I can either let it go, I can understand how is this a tool for me to grow. And I wanted to mention too about how the light languages actually they are a constant communication. They are really the source of light. They are the language of light. They really are the language of source energy. They are the languages of, and how many now people are starting to call it the actual universal language, because now there's so many of us that are actually, it sounds almost like the same language. And yet we also have to understand there is an infinite number of languages. We couldn't possibly identify them all. We can't. And as we're creating hybrid children and families, we're creating hybrid languages. That it's an alchemy, a complete new alchemy of energy. This is a whole new ball game. And so you're going to be receiving all these new information, all these new energies, new languages, and part of what you, me, what we're here to do is enlighten each other and activate each other with these languages. So that's a big part of this ascension process. And even if I don't understand why or how, all I need to know is
the moment.
It excites me and I want to share it. And that's what the message is here. If it excites you and you want to share it, it is your highest joy at the moment. And it doesn't need to be, oh, this is what I'm going to be doing in a year or a month or a week. It's just now. You only have now, so share it. There doesn't need to be a reason. There doesn't need to be an end. There doesn't need to be a process. If you want to do it now, put it out there. Even if you don't do it again or it doesn't matter. That's the whole point is there is no destination. It is about the journey. Therefore,
it's just doing it.
Do it and do it now without expectation, without question. If it brings you joy, then spread it and have no, where is it going to take me? Because that actually stalls the process. It stops the creation in its tracks. As soon as we start to analyze it and pick it apart, we compartmentalize it, judge it, and half the time it never even gets out the door because we've judged it to death and now we've decided we aren't worthy enough to put it out for the world. That's what this is about, you guys. If it feels you joy, take it, put it out there, do it, and let it go. And be joyous and don't worry about where it takes you, where it's supposed to go, what's going to happen, blah, 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 blah. If you get the inclination to go a different way, drive a new way, try a new job, try a new food, do it because it's your higher self going, you want to go on this particular path. This is how to get there. You asked me for the answer and I'm giving it to you. Take it. That knowing, that instinct, that excitement is the answer. It is the answer. That's the point. Don't judge it. Don't hide it. Don't stifle it. Just do it and stop judging it. Stop expecting it to be and let it be its thing for its thing. When you write something, a poem, a drawing, you're just doing it for the doing it. And at that point, it's about the joy. It's not about the painter doesn't just paint a painting and sit there and go, okay, I hope I sell it. They keep painting and they keep painting and they keep painting. And then as frequency brings them to say to the people who enjoy his painting, then they get bought. But if he sits there in his house and never puts his paintings out there, how's anybody going to know that he's an artist? So this is what we're all here to do is to show each other. I love to do this. I love to do that. There's not one person in this room, in this hangout, that isn't out there doing something, following their joy, showing their love, sending their bliss, sharing their bliss. Every single person in this room is. And we're all masters. This is the master class. That's why it's so hard. And that's why we're first. You're the teachers to teach the teachers. We're the teachers to teach the teachers. So with that said, I'm going to see if anybody else would like to do a language blessing, specifically Bree, if you need to go. I love you too, sweetie. I love you. If you guys want to maybe put yourselves in line for blessings and any last comments. And Brian, I know, is doing also private sessions now. Contact me at languagesoflights@gmail.com. If there's anything that, I mean, channeling, activations, guidance, I started doing oracle card readings with a native spirit deck. And so there's all kinds of things that we all have in our toolbox, in our repertoire. You don't need to stick yourself into one box. I'm this, I'm that, I channel this, I channel that, I do. You know what? Expand yourselves, guys. You do it all. I've channeled everything from angels to the blue avians to the trees to the the air collectives, the as long as you're open, I mean, elves, fairies, I know I'm leaving a bunch out, I'm sorry. the Yahyel, the I am so close, I have so much Yahyel and Shekinah DNA. I'm always bringing the information from the Sasani Shekinah collective consciousness. It's just who I am. And so we all have to embrace who we are, because there's always another side to that coin that needs you. Somebody needs you. I think every single person in this room, well, we're all channelers, all of us. And it's wonderful to see everybody springing out there and starting their own stuff, their own channels, their own, you know, sessions. There's how many, I think what they said by 2050, there's going to be 9.5 billion people on this planet. There's only a few of us that are, you know, we all need to start to show the way. And the showing the way simply means being who you are. That's it. That's all that means. Okay, I'll stop.
Yeah, can you all hear me?
Yes, go right ahead. Anybody who'd like to start blessings, go right ahead.
Yeah, I was just going to let people know how they can get a hold of me.
Please do.
Through my YouTube page. Just type in Brian Sims and then look for this, just like my profile pic on here with the man with the hat. Just look for this picture, and you'll scroll down under Brian Sims and you'll find me, and just go to the about page, and it's got all my contact information. If you can get a hold of me, I do private sessions. Mostly what I specialize is in the shadow energies, working with bringing out the best in people, going deeper within the individual, really bringing out the best of them, clearing a lot of blockages, breaking through, you know, going beyond, moving beyond shame, doubt, fear, you know, stuff like that. So yes, so if anybody would love a session with me, just like a 1-hour session, get a hold of me. Much love and light. Thank you very much.
Awesome, Brian. Thank you so much. And I know there's a couple people who would like to give some blessings. And would you like to give a blessing right now, Brian?
No. I'm good. Go ahead and just let Will and Sarah. And then you
okay,
guys.
Great.
I'm good.
Okay, great.
Thank
so,
you.
Yeah, Will, go right ahead. And I'll watch and see if there's anybody else who'd like to as well.
Wendy, thank you so much. You're totally awesome. You rock.
Well, thank you, Will. You rock as well. And I did want to mention, too, that I've been working very closely with Will and Katie on the Aquarian Fire energy healing. And it has become a great... powerful love of mine. And I wanted to thank Will for bringing that to our, Will and Jim, for bringing that to our awareness and our attention in our Beyond Belief retreat. And since that time, it has been a huge spark in my heart. So I wanted to put that out there as well and thank Will for all that he has done for all of us and me personally, especially in the last couple of weeks. It's been a wild ride. And so thank you, Will. I just wanted to put that out there for you too, that Reiki with Will, find Will on. He does a lot of great channeling videos now and doing light language videos. And of course is doing Reiki there in Austin, Texas. So I just wanted to thank him for the world to hear.
Yes. Thank you, Wendy. You're my sister. I love you so much. Divine blessings to you, my sister. an infinite flow of love coming from me to you.
And to you.
So, Will, you said that you're in Austin.
Yes, I'm in Austin.
I am definitely in Austin, Texas as well, until January 8th. So if you want to meet up.
Oh, sure. Absolutely.
Well, see, I guess there was a reason why I was guided to say it out loud. So awesome.
You got it.
Awesome.
Totally cool.
No, that's okay. That's okay.
We're still on the air, so why don't we finish
Will,
the blessings
want,
and then we can chat after we go off air.
Did you want to finish your blessing, Will?
Yes, please.
Thank you.
Ishiniota tawarana hasekiacha. Ana hoso to tukushia taguara se shia or to kushinia tatakayatasa. Aran hakuhushi warana hayakatasana achiara hukutu tsunuya. Hishior no hukuyara. Nawaratsasaya shesho kono no tosisiana takiach shikotuhuya tasa. Hior no hoshikotokoshiana. And so it is. Much love.
Yasha, thank you. Namaste, brother. Kyakole Asya. Okay, sure. Sarah's next, though, please. Thank you.
Ushia do kushia niokoli sukutua. Somoko toko tishia ko niaka tu shotoaha siduka hashu tunku nana isalatako a sukutuluku siantuku nikaka sokuko ania sana katuko tuaha. Namaste.
Namaste, sister. Nia soto shibiki ala siana sato haki atorasima. I gathered a few things from that, and what I heard was briefly, you are all gathering your strength, and you are stronger than any of you know, any of you realize. You have come to walk and step into your great power, your sovereignty. You are all kings and queens, gods and goddesses. We step today into this power and knowing that we are one in our sovereignty and that we are strong and support each other as one.
Blessings, Wendy. Namaste.
Thank you, Sarah. Love you.
Love you.
And would you like to go next? All right.
If you desire, we shall speak.
And then I'll close after that. Oh,
This is what we shall say to you. If you understand, we have accomplished what we say.
Thank you. Namaste. Blessings.
Yes. And then.
Pete, did you have a blessing for us today as well? Thank you. Namaste. We invite you all now to open your heart spaces and allow the light codes of unconditional love and acceptance of yourselves and your brothers and sisters, that you see each other in nothing but your truest, highest light. For you are all created equally in the eyes of Source. Each of you, a special child. Each of you, a timeless, endless consciousness. Once you are, you are. Anything less than honoring this isness is dishonoring creation. For you are needed and necessary, for you were created to tell your story, your multidimensional story, in every expression of joy you possibly can. And when we say of joy, even anger, frustration is love and joy, for it teaches you love and joy. Everything is for expansion, for you, by you, in agreement, completely in agreement. Intend every moment, every day, to see the joy, to see your beauty, how unconditionally loved you are. When you gaze upon a thing of beauty that brings you deep joy, peace, love, excitement, when you weep at the experience, that is but a fraction of how you are loved, a fraction. There is no judgment. You are not being judged. You are perfect. You are having an experience, sharing a story. Just like the television, the movies, the books, they're all to teach. For nothing teaches like experience, and nothing teaches like the tales of those experiences. But yet you must experience the experience. This is but a fraction, a moment, an illusion. Spend it wisely. What energetic currency are you generating and are you spending? Where are you spending your energy? Are you focusing on lack or love? For even lack is love, it's just a perception. No, you will always have everything you need to do, what you need to do, when you need to do it. You are a creator. You create that which you see around you by frequency of focus. Focus creates focus creates. Nulea tasania pakalubi arasotor shialahi. Mekoraki satarshin ayaraki lanturesi palakanira sokwala senaya alaki tarasa. Sotorosho malalia nara katorosokwa paimera. Mohayala heyo nyaya lehenua shunaya he senoya helanu he hala he heya. You are all shaman, that you bring the energy, the experience, the knowledge to the earth from the spirit realms, from higher dimensions, to benefit the human collective community. You are all messengers from the stars. And you have come here to perform a great job, a great mission. Nandira sola lemba la kni andaro so blandira soko sotor shibala satarisima li andaro so. They are all here. Dia sotor shomiala. Dia sotor soma. They are always here with you. Your DNA is awakening, empowering you to feel your Pleiadian selves, your Arcturian selves, your Lyran selves, Lemurian, Atlantean, Egyptian. You are all there. It is all a part of your existence, your energies. Ask for the knowledge that you need in every given moment, for you will always receive what you need when you need it. Believe. The one is the all, and the all are the one, and you all are the all, for you are the one. You are the one fractal. Yet you are infinite. And the numbers of you are infinite. Nia Toresi began, Sotoshumaya, Waluamaya, Satashina, Atoresia. And you are perfect, and we are perfect. And in this now, every now, you are always perfect. Tia Sotoshumia Alakoha. We are one heartbeat. Mashunia Kaheumayasana. Mahala, namaste. Walk in light. Thank you all for being here.
Thank you, Wendy, for all those blessings and for everybody else who gave blessings. Wendy, did you give your contact information as well as Brian?
It's languages of lights at gmail.com, and I'm on YouTube as Languages of Lights. I'm also on Facebook as Languages of Lights, and I think everywhere else too. but Languages of Lights at Gmail, you can contact me at any time. And I'm also Wendy Wolf on there too, so you can contact me through Wendy Wolf as well. So I have both pages, Languages of Lights and Wendy Wolf. You can find me in both places. And my email address at Wendy Wolf is bohemian1111@gmail.com. Thank you, Mark. And if there's any last announcements for Human Colony?
Well, I'll just give out the donation link, humancolony.org/donate, if anybody wants to contribute to keep these webinars going. And then if no one has any, does anybody else have any announcements to add before we go off air?
Other than just visit the site, there's Reiki classes. I believe Will's going to be doing Reiki classes as well in Austin. Human Colony, the webinars are always looking for additional technical support. Anyone who's interested in moderating, channeling, we're always looking for people to join our channel panel. Jim Charles, of course, is our main channeler. Please visit him, Human Colony, for private sessions with him. And as each of us start sharing our information, we support each other. So thank you.
And I believe Jim will be the channeler next Saturday as well.
Excellent. And I wanted to wish you all, no matter what you're celebrating, this weekend or any weekend, and I wish you all a very happy, prosperous new year. This is new beginnings, truly, for all of us. This is an epic time, and we need to reach out to each other and be there for each other. So it's going to be a crazy year of abundance and awareness and excitement, and I'm so honored and grateful to share it with all of you. Thank you so much for being here.
And with that, I want to thank everybody for watching and participating and everybody who helped. And we'll go off air. Again, thank you for watching Hucolo TV. Namaste.
Namaste.